Now, with an aquarium, when you run an air pump, it will typically look like this, and the air pump will generally go down in the cabinet, and then the air pump will grow air from an air line to a check to a air stone, and that's where the bubbles come out. And it's really important you have a check valve, and then the it looks like an arrow going that way in the way that the air goes. And if you put it the wrong way, it will not work. So it has to be that way. So it goes from here through the check valve and into the air stone, and that's where the bubbles come out. But if you are going to add any things like an air controller, which you can slow down the flow, you always want to put the air controller on this side of the check valve, not on that side of the check valve. Because if the pump turns off, if you did not have that stuff, the water will flow back in and create a leak and blow up your pump. If the check valve's here, then the water can't go in and blow up the pump. But it's also better to, it's better if possible, to have the air controller here. That way, if any water does go back to the check valve, which if there is a check valve is unlikely, but if that was to occur, these things are usually not completely watertight. So it's safer, just in case it's not completely watertight. So it's safer to put them on that side of the check valve. This is an unlikely problem, but because it's slightly possible, it's easier to put it there.